Okay guys, we're dragging the Christmas tree around back. And we're gonna set it on fire. Monkey's at work. And she said, come on Bruno. She said we wish we had a camera around back so she could watch it. So I told her I'd film it for her. So we're gonna bring it back here to the burning pile. And I'm gonna use my striker and we'll see how quick we can get this thing to go up, and I'm going to try to get it to stand up because it's a lot cooler. So hang tight and we'll get this thing going. Alright, so got my little fire striker here. I'm going to try it first, and if it don't work then we're going to stuff this in there and we'll light this. That'll make it go. But let's just see. Still have water in it, but it is still kind of dry. Alright. Now, let's try our... This stuff hasn't... It never fails, usually. But I have had it fail, like if you're washing sheets that are fire retardant, or blankets or something. I think it might be what they had in it right now, but let's try this. There it goes. It was lit like on the second try, but all right, let's see what happens. I'll sit down here beside you guys. That sucks. I did have my water hose right here beside us, just in case something goes awry. Now, if that was standing up, that would have been gone by now, guaranteed. But as you can see, if this was in your house, you know, that's pretty hot. I gotta back you guys up too. Woo! I think that piece there, I think that's from last year's tree, if I'm not mistaken. Woo! Dang. Wow. We're back about 15 feet now. I'm gonna take a picture of that and send it to Monkey. I sent her a couple second clip. And like I said, as you can see, that if that got out of hand in your house, I mean, your whole living room, dining room, wherever you have that set up, would be gone right now. Really? Well, huh. I gotta go grab another one out of the shed. Okay, I got this one. It's plastic, so I gotta be careful with it. Are you fucking kidding me? These things, well, I know the one was left outside, but I didn't think this one was. Well, I got my water hose here just in case, so I'll just sit out here for a couple minutes and have a cold beer and talk to you guys for a minute. Okay, guys, so go sit here for a few minutes, have a cold beer with you. Man, that looks like a mobile home behind me with that tarp on it like that. Not that there's anything wrong with that. I lived in a mobile home once. Twice, actually. Once when I was a kid and once I had my own. Well, I rented it. I didn't own it. But, just trying to get money. It's going to cost around $12,000. To do that roof, so, but that's everything. That's, you know, that's all the fascia work, and of course not gutters, but this house never had gutters. But that's all the fascia work and the cap and all that stuff. You know, there's like three soil stacks on there. I think it's got lead on them right now, but they'll replace those. But that's the whole nine yards. That's all the wood, the sheeting. We call it, they just call it wood down here. I'm messaging Monkey back and forth because they showed her a picture of the rakes, and she said, well, you fixed one once for me. And I was like, yeah, I did, but I can't remember which one. I think it was the first one that broke. The second one I don't think I fixed. And she was like, you'll have to fix them. I'm like, or now hear me out, or we can just get a new one. She says, well, I like you to fix things, so maybe I'll let you fix them. She was joking, but she told me, she said, this is cool. You know, I can't give out locations, but she's, you know, in the office. It says, I think there's a ghost in here. Things are falling. The house is shaking. I don't know why she called it a house. It's an office building, but I think it's a single story though, you know. Again, for whatever. Oh, she said, or whatever you want to call this office. So I don't know if it's a house or if it was a house and they made it into an office, but yeah, so that's pretty interesting. But, you know, I mean, she's got, you know, she's in the office, and her other worker, she ended up going to the hospital because she got sick. She had the shots, and the physical therapists are all sick, the nurses are all sick, and two other people just got sick yesterday. Yesterday, one of the owner showed up. It's a private company that does the health care, and he left on the ground. You know, he brought some supplies, some masks and some gloves, you know, for the workers. But he left them on the ground. He wouldn't get out of his truck. He wouldn't come and talk to her. He didn't want no part of it. And he's the owner, okay? Now, that's what gets me. Because he knows, you know, everybody's getting sick. Now, Monkey is the only one that hasn't gotten sick, and she hasn't had any of the shots. So, you know, take that with a grain of salt. I usually don't talk about that stuff on here. But, you know, they say, what is it, the heroes behind the scenes or whatever. Well, you know, like I said, they don't mention CNAs. not only mention doctors and physicians and those kind of people, but what about the CNAs? She was in more homes than the nurses were. She was around more patients than the nurses were, you know. But anyway, she's on light duty. That's why they got her in the office. But, you know, this week she's been there all by herself because, you know, the other woman that had gotten sick, well, she got better, came back, I think, 1 or 2 days, and she got sick again. And she's been doing some work from home, but she's really sick again. And she's had the shots. So, I don't know what's going on there. And, you know, she's scared to death. I'm scared to death because, you know, she could bring something home to us. But at least she's in the office by herself. Like yesterday, she wouldn't let anybody in. If somebody needed something, she would put it in their bag or whatever and set it outside the door, and they would come and pick it up. So, you know, even when the other girl was working there, you know, they wore their masks. So it just doesn't make sense. Everybody has had their shots except for her, and she's the only person that has not gotten sick. And the 22nd of this month, they're mandating to where if you don't have your shots, they're going to fire you. So they're going to make her take a shot for something that hasn't bothered her since she's been there. But everybody else that had the shots have all been sick and missing work and out of work. Because, you know, you can't come to work sick like that. And so, you know, if she don't get her shots, they're going to fire her. She's the only one that hasn't been sick. Anyway, that's my little rant that pisses me off. You know, I mean, come on. You know, I'm not against it. I just ain't going to do it. You know, I'm not going to be forced to put something in my body I don't want in my body. And she feels the same way. You know, we shouldn't have to be forced to do that. As far as wearing a mask out in public, I get it. I'll do that with no problem. But you're not going to force me to stick a needle in my arm and put something in me, I don't know what it is, when they say it's better for you, and then you gotta get a booster shot after you get the first two shots and all this, and then what's next? Another booster, and people still getting sick, people still dying from this. It really upsets me, you know. So anyway, and yes, we've been tested. None of us here has had it, and we wanna keep it that way. And so, okay, she sent me a... Okay, she figured out why the building's shaking. I know you probably can't see it, but there's a big D9 in the back field there, so... Yep, that'll do it. Yep, that'll cause it to shake. So, anyway, but, you know, I mean... It should be to each his own, you know what I'm saying? And they'll tell you that shot don't keep you from getting sick, it keeps you from dying if you get sick. No, if it's your time to go, it's your time to go, you know? I mean, I smoke half a pack of cigarettes a day, I cut down from 3.5 packs. Well, now you need to stop. I said, look, you're not taking everything away from me, you know. Like I had one young punk-ass doctor said, if you quit smoking, I guarantee I can put 10 years on your life. So you're going to guarantee me that I'm not driving down the road or I'm not going out checking my mail and get hit by a drunk driver? Well, no. So you can't guarantee me 10 years on my life. I told him straight up, you're not God, you know. My saying is, you know, I put my health and my body in the hands of God, not physicians, because physicians aren't God. You know, I do take my blood thinners. I do take them every day. But I mean, I'm not going to be forced to put something in my body. I don't think anybody should. Well, you know, it's your career, or you can go get the shot for something that hasn't made you sick yet. Just. It upsets me, you know. Yeah, doctors say, yeah, you quit smoking, you'll live another 10 years. Now, how long you figure I got now? You might live to be in your 70s. I'm good with that, because pretty much my 95% of my family has all died in their mid-70s, so except for like my mom and stuff. But, you know, that seems like the cutting off point. I'm like... You know, I mean, you can't guarantee somebody something like, if you quit smoking, you'll live 10 years longer. Where do they come up with that? You know? I mean, I've had two doctors tell me, you know, your lungs are fine, because I started smoking late. Your lungs are fine, so if you quit smoking now, it's not going to matter, because, you know, it'll be something else that gets you. Just like my stroke, I've had a lot of comments about that. That's what, smoking caused your stroke. No, it didn't. A hole in my heart caused my stroke, you know. And, you know, we're all born with a hole in our heart, but they usually heal over, grow over, you know. It's like babies, they got soft spots. But mine didn't. Now, usually in those cases, you're pretty much an outpatient. You go in, they fix it, you know, put a patch on it. You're in there a day or so, 2 days maybe, whatever. You know, it's just a quick procedure, nothing to it, and they can fix it. But when I went in to get mine done, I was prepped and ready, man. They shaved me and everything, and, you know, I was all ready to go, just waiting on the doctor. The doctor come in and says, "You ready to go?" And I'm like, "Yeah, I'm ready. Let's do this." He says, "You know, it's not a big deal." But he says, "You know what?" He said, "I want to take a look at your images again. I just want to be sure." He come back about 20 minutes later and says, "I'm not going to do it." He says, this is what worried me, is this doctor actually said, "I burnt that bridge before." He says, "You have an aneurysm around that hole." He says, it's flapping. He says, "If we try to put a patch on that," and I like the way this doctor was pretty cool, because he wasn't from here. He was from Leesburg. I mean, he knew his stuff, but he says, "You're a mechanic, so I'm sure you've patched tubes before." And I said, "Yeah, I patched tire tubes before." He says, "There's a reason why you don't get that wrinkle, right?" And I said, "Yeah, it'll leak." He said, same way there. He says, "You got a wrinkle around your heart, around that hole. It's called an aneurysm." He said, "If we try to patch it, it could be a lot worse, possibly even kill you." Okay, so we heard that, so we made... So, and he talked to, because that was a team of doctors, he talked to his colleagues, and nobody wanted to do it. So we went to Shands in Gainesville, and had a team of doctors check me out. They ran all kinds of tests, and then they called me back in, and it was like, "We're not going to do it either." I said, and Monkey said, "So it can be patched?" I said, "Normally, yes, but he's 1 in 1,000 cases that there's nothing they can do." But he said, "Let me go talk to my colleagues." 30 minutes later, he came back. He said, "Look, we don't want to do this." He said that the chances of it getting worse are higher than the chances of it making better. He says it's probably not going to work, and it'll probably make it worse. That's two teams of doctors that told me that. There's nothing they can do. 1 in 1,000 case. Had to be that one. But... You know, so, but anyway, you know, back to, it's just, you know, the shot thing. I think if you want to get it, go ahead, go for it. You know, if that's what you want to do, I'm not against it. I'm just against me taking it. I don't want to take it, you know. I mean, I'm not going to. Well, I don't have to, but they're threatening her job, her career, if she don't go get a shot, to keep her from getting sick from something that she hasn't been sick with yet. And the whole office, everybody, like I said, even the field people, they're all getting bronchitis, pneumonia, and all that stuff. Cause, you know, it's COVID, I'll say it. You know, I guess they'll demonetize this, but, you know, and she's the only one that hasn't been sick in any way, you know, not even so much as a cold. And, you know, like I said, their patients, you know, they don't have nurses that can go in. They're sick. They can't go in sick, taking care of patients, you know, getting them sick. Physical therapists, the office people. Like I said, she's pretty much 2 weeks been there by herself because everyone is sick. And when the owner don't even want to get out of the truck and come and talk to you or hand you this stuff, he didn't even go in the building and set it on her desk or anything. He just sat it down on the ground, I guess by the door or whatever, and he waved at her and left. That's it. He wouldn't even go in the damn building. He would not go in the office. But yet he expects them to be out there doing it. Yeah, I'm not going to do that because, you know, I don't want to take that chance, but you better go do it. And you better get your shot or I'm going to fire you. I told her, you know what, let them fire you. Screw that, you know. She's looking for a job when she found this one. I'm over people pressuring me. You should get the shot. You should do this and it'll make you better. And no. I mean, it's getting bad down here. Hell, they close. Her aunt and uncle, they'll be here tomorrow. They're going to come over and spend the day with us. But they come down, which they didn't get to last year. Well, they didn't get to, last year and a year before last because the borders were closed because they're from Canada. They come down every year for a couple months. And they go over New Smyrna Beach and they stay over there in a condo. And they just made it. They just got in. They closed the borders. Just so we don't know how long they'll be closed. So they might be stuck down here for a while. But, you know, I mean, it's getting bad down here. Really bad down here. Nobody wears masks. You know, Monkey wears too. Or wherever she goes. I always put on a mask. But I stay home a lot. You know. But, like, if we got to go to the store or something. You know, you got to do that. But you have to, you know, you wear your mask. I mean... And people's not wearing a mask, they don't understand. You know, you guys that are against wearing masks, it's not for you anyway, it's for the next person. So you don't give somebody something. And you can still be a carrier, even though you get that shot, because you can still get it. So you can still be a carrier, but you don't have to wear your mask. But this person that hasn't been vaccinated, that hasn't got it, hasn't been sick, he's not allowed to do nothing. I don't care. You know, I really don't care, you know. I mean, as long as we can go to the store and get some supplies here and there, I'm good with that. If I got to wear a mask out, I'm good with that, okay? I'm not against that. I'm against forcing someone to put something in your body. And if you don't, you know, your career's gone. Yet that same person won't even go in the office because they're scared. But yet you better get that shot and you better go to work every day. But I'm not going in. Nope, I'm gonna set that stuff over there. You know, that's not right. That's bullshit. So anyway, guys, that's my little rant. I know I said that once already. So, fire's pretty well down now. Well, the fire's down, just got a little bit of smoke there. I'm gonna go ahead and wet that down. And see what else we can get into. So, anyway, stick around, I'm sure. There'll be more to come. Okay, so this is what Monkey's wanting to do. Monkey wants to put a like a bird feeder out here and get some bird feed and stuff and put a live stream on the bird feed because she's been watching these birds. People's been doing that. And I guess they're really liking it, the live stream of watching the birds. I told her, sure, I'll build your bird feeder and we can do that, but problem I'm having is we've got so many squirrels here. That's why we don't get birds in our bird houses that I built, because the squirrels get in there and the squirrels chase the birds away. Same way with the bird baths. She's got a couple bird baths and it's very rare to see a bird in them because usually you see the squirrels in them. So it may turn out to be a squirrel live stream. I don't know, because you know, you go putting bird seed out here, them squirrels are really going to come in. I know the other day I let Bruno out here, and there was four in this one tree over here by the shed, and there was one over here by the garden, over here to my left. And so, I don't know, so it may end up be a squirrel live stream thing, but, you know, whatever she wants, we'll do it. I don't care. She's like, well, I just thought it was a good idea. Because she's excited about it. And I'm like, no, we can do it. It just may, we may catch more squirrels than birds. But, you know, at least it'll be some kind of wildlife. So, we want to do, well, she wants to do that for a while. So, I told her, you know, yeah, I'll build you a bird feeder. So, I was going to do it this weekend. But I don't know because, you know, her aunt and uncle, she talked to them last night. And they want to come over tomorrow for a while, and you know, because they haven't seen, you know, that's her mom's sister and her husband. that's coming. So, you know, she hasn't seen her in a couple years. So they want to come over. So I'm going to make some homemade chicken noodle soup for them. And, you know, they don't like heat. Randy, you know, they're getting up there in years, so Randy, he don't like to drive at night, so they'll be here pretty early, and they'll leave early so they can get back there before dark, because it's like a two-hour drive, I think, something like that from here, because, you know, that's on the other coast of Florida. So but yeah, so we're talking about doing that, so probably do that for a little bit and see how that goes. And I think it's a great idea. I just don't think we'll get many birds, because the squirrels, I think, is just going to come in and eat up all the, because I've put bird seed out here before. We used to feed the birds, but the squirrels pretty much ate them. Some birds will come, but hopefully some of the birds can get in there and get some feed too, and get in the bird baths and get their drinks and whatnot. So we're gonna try that. I got that all, the fire's all out now. So yeah, just want to bring you along with that, kind of like a little vlog type thing. Sorry about the rain. It's just, you know, I mean, somebody threatens you with your career, your job, your livelihood, you know, because they think something's good for you, but them themselves won't even go into the office that they make her go into every day, 8 hours a day. I just don't think it's fair, and I don't think it's right. So, you know, I know if it was my job, but it's easier for me when I was allowed to work. I mean, I can find work anywhere. I can do pretty much there is anything to do, but you know, somebody threatened me like that, I would have walked that day. It's really, she's the only one they got working right now, because everybody else is sick. So, yeah, if they don't appreciate you more than that, you know, they expect you to do stuff they don't even want to come close to doing, I just don't think it's right. I would have told them, you know what, see, I'm walking. But that's just me, you know, because, you know, I can find a job in 2 days. It doesn't matter. But, you know, she loves her job, and she loves her career. And to have somebody threaten her career like that, it's just not right. And they don't even want to go into the office they own because they're so scared, but yet they expect everybody else to do it. It's not fair. All right, well, let me see. See if there's anything else to talk about.
Okay, so thought I'd just come out and take a few of these lights down so she don't have to worry about it. She usually takes the stuff down every year, but just to help her out a little bit, I'll go ahead and get some of this stuff. Get some of this stuff taken care of. Hope you guys can hear me. Got the wireless mic on. Well, I borrowed hers. Okay, so there's this. All right, I'm done. okay, so check. All right. We love the lights, though. Thought they turned out pretty good this year for not having a lot. Next year, if all goes well, next year we should have quite a bit of stuff up. Like I said, if everything goes right. Alright, now I need to get that taken down up there. I'll bring you over here with me. hope everyone's having a good new year so far. Remember, well, as a kid, we never decorated the house, but we always had a lot of lights on our tree because we always had a nice tree. But remember my mom, because every year you're going to have to buy a new strand of lights pretty much. Well, a couple years we didn't, but anyway, all these lights, that's when they had the styrofoam, you know, inside the light boxes. Man, we used to have to put all these lights back in the boxes the way they came out. Oh my God, that was rough. And that took some time, because you know, you just get them out of the boxes, you just pop them out, put them back in, you know, running them wires and putting each bulb into its own little hole that it went into. Yeah. And I thought she had it rough, because she said when she was a kid, her mom, my grandmother, when they put the tinsel on the tree, the silver stuff, we call them icicles, they used to have to put it on one strand at a time. Well, when she got on her own, of course, she wasn't going to do that anymore. They had what they called a tree drape. It was the icicles, but it was all one piece. And you'd start at the top and it would go down, you know, over the tree, right? She said those were bad too. They don't make them anymore. They haven't made them in many, 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 many years. But you would walk past and the static, that thing would jump out and snap you, you know, one of them. Because I remember we used to do that, rub our feet on the carpet and go over and watch the thing come out and snap us and see the sparks. Yeah. Just, you know, reminiscing. I know a lot of you younger people don't think a lot about that right now, but you will when you get my age. You know, 53 this month, so. Yeah, you guys will be doing the same thing, talking about, you know, it's the little stuff, you know what I mean? The little stuff that you miss, and just things like that. That, you know, nothing stays the same, just part of life. But you can always, you know, they can't take this room. They can't take it, you know. I don't even think you guys are in shot now. Or I'm in shot. But you can't, you know, they can't take it all from you, you know. You still have your memories. And I got a sun glare. Let me move you over here. There we go. Got you in the shade. Man, I was out back. I was going to talk to you guys some more out back, but geez, I was getting eat up by mosquitoes like you would not believe. This is going to be in the near future, this project. I was going to do it this week, but well, I didn't. I've got the wood I need. I'm just going to use the same hardware, and I'll use this as a template. A lot of sirens today. Now, let's see if I can do this. Did this last year and I fell on my ass. There we go. We did it. Now, I'll get these ones down off the house for her. This is her hook for her hummingbirds. that Brian and Marla sent to her. She really loves these things. Okay, here we go. Okay, here we go. There, we got them guys up there. It's so pretty at night too. They don't last a long time because they don't get full sunlight out here. And you still didn't see nothing, did you? Oh, well, anyway, I was up there. Oh, geez. All right. So, I'm going to try to get you guys out of the sun. So, I'm going to take these lights down off the front here. It doesn't start getting real tall until I get over on that end. For some reason, you would think this would be the tall end, but it's not. Probably because I'm up on this pavement. And I hope the mic's still working. I do have those plastic clips that you clip these lights on with, but they break a lot. Especially up north when they get cold, they'll break. Down here, the heat gets to them, they break. So I just put some drywall screws in, like inch and a quarter, drove them in, and just kind of give it one wrap. You know, just kind of go around it once and keep going. Here now, take our gigantic ball down. Check. Okay, I like this camera's got analog on it, so as you're talking you can see that your mic's working, or if I'm on one side or the other, you know, it corresponds to that, so that's handy. Because your mic can stop working anytime, I can periodically check, you know, and know if my mic's working. So that's a great feature on this AX53. So apparently my drone's back, or it's done, it's on its way back. It'll be here Tuesday, the 11th. They got it, what was it, the 5th? They got it the 4th. Anyway, they had it one day and had it fixed, and it's supposed to be being sent back. So I don't know if they fixed it that quick or if it couldn't be fixed and they just sent me another one, but that was fast. So hopefully, it can be fixed. That's not the issue. Sometimes to fix something is not feasible for a big company, you know, to pay their workers so many hours a time to fix a drone when they can just send them a new one. Might be better off doing it that way. So I don't know if that's what they did, but anyway, it's on its way here back already. So I know they were supposed to, if they couldn't fix it or if it wasn't feasible for them to fix it, they're supposed to send me a new one. So hopefully they didn't screw up and drop the ball and just go, we can't fix it, and send it back to me, because we got 2-year warranty on that thing. Well, it's insurance, not a warranty, it's insurance. The only thing they don't cover is theft or being run over by a car. So, there we go. Got this, this ball down. That's hanging down there. It looks like it's full of water over here. That looks like that's full of water up there. Yep, it is. Probably gonna get wet. These, I think they're called elephant ears. Man, they're taking over. So, when I hung these lights, when I was doing all these lights here, the little snowmen, I couldn't remember where Monkey got them. They were her mother's. That's probably why I couldn't remember. But yeah, they were her mom's. So they're very old. You can tell, you can tell by the plastic on them that, yeah, they're very old. So, gotta be real careful with them. I think they got them regular bulbs in them too. Whew. Yeah, I think I'm gonna try to go with some LEDs next year. If we can come up with the extra money, because that stuff's expensive. I want to choreograph them to lights or to music. All right, now that's down. Now I gotta roll the wire up. Well, the light's up. You know what I mean, right? Let's see. All right. Yeah, just kinda, you know, doing a little bit of this and that for her. Now, the last night we had these lights on, the ones over at the window, half of them went out and the other half started blinking. Next night, they weren't blinking anymore, but the other half was still not on. So I'm probably just going to dispose of those ones. And well, I usually try to save some of them for, you know, bulbs. I always get bulbs running out or burning out. So I don't know. All right. Damn, sun's bright. It's hot out here, guys. Like I said, I was around back. Here it is. January 7th. And getting eat up by mosquitoes and sweating my tail end off here. What I do is always go backwards from the way I put them up. You know what I mean? So if I ended here, that's where I'll start taking them back down. Sweat going in my eyes. Probably ruined my hat. This is my good hat. This is one with the lights on it. Alright. Yeah, I'll probably save this strand. Also, guys, what you can do is if you got a string of these lights that are out, you can save them because they work great as extension cords for other lights. I'm not talking about plugging in an air conditioner in it or nothing like that. No toasters. But, you know, to plug in, like, you want a set of lights over here, you don't have an extension cord. Well, here's your extension cord. You plug this in, then you run the end of it over to where you got to run it. There's your extension cord. So I may save it just for that, because I used absolutely every extension cord I had. Well, I've been doing that for a couple years now. So when I need one, I really don't have one, you know what I mean? So, all right, guys, I guess I'm going to call this video here. Thanks for joining me. I appreciate it. Thanks for listening to me, to my little chat, my talk, my vlog, I guess you can call it. Yes, there's not much now. Just getting stuff packed up and put away, and yeah, we're there. So anyway, guys, again, thanks for watching, appreciate it. Shea Bear, the myth, the man, a legend. I'm gone for now. Please swing past and visit Monkey's channel. Give her some support, would you? She needs it. She's been upset, so and you can't blame her. So anyway, guys, again, thanks for watching, appreciate it. We'll see you guys in the next one, so stay tuned for more videos, and we'll keep the camera rolling on this end. You guys do the same when you're in. Bye-bye, guys. Take care. Have a great weekend.